So we gonna check out this Iowa 80 trucking museum. So they open. How you doing? Nah.
Alright, well, welcome. There is no fee to walk here. We welcome donations and flying. Pictures are welcome, but please don't touch your trucks, exhibits, or crossing over the barriers. There is a guest room. You're welcome to sign
it. Okay, I'll sign that as soon as I walk out.
Yeah, no problem.
Thank you. Yes, ma'am. Thank you. What is this? Oh, Federal Diesel. Think about it, y'all. This is what this is what started it all. I mean, this ain't the one that started it all. That one looked like that one was before this one though, but yeah, just looking at the museum. Obviously, them ain't the same original tires in the back here. The thing looked all going brand new. Now the ones up front might be close to original. This is a 1903 two-cylinder hose piston gasoline engine. 10 miles an hour is the top speed. And this was produced before the Model T, according to this sign right here. So this is older than a Model T Ford. So they redid the wheels and tires.
Said it had rotted away. Gas pumps. All the different types and models of gas pumps that they had back in the day.
So what they're saying is, it's like when you get fuel, I know for this kind right here, and that one, all the ones with glass on the top, what they'll do is they'll fill it up based on how many
gallons you want. And then when they get it there,
then they'll take it and pump it into your truck, in or out of your truck. Snow plow. It's amazing how far we've came. we have this one here. According to the sign, this is an electric truck. This is a dairy company. So this was a quote unquote refrigerated truck. In 1906, they had electric vehicles, and everybody said Tesla was the pioneer of electric vehicles. Yeah, look at 1906. Yeah, pioneer nothing. First known vehicle, electric vehicle, 1842. First known electric powered vehicle. Modern toys of old trucks. And airplanes. Yeah, there's an airplane down there. Just one airplane. Two airplanes. Hat pins from trucking companies. So I'm gonna start over here, over this way. Other versions of fuel pumps. Loopsters, oil dispensers, not fuel pumps. One of the first truck scales. like an octopus tentacle. That's what that look like. A Chevy made it into the game. Oh, that's a Ford. Chevy. Jeep. So it takes 2 years to restore one of these trucks. It's a Ford right here, Ford Ranger. But that sign says 250. That's a Ranger. All right. Big job, Ford. I wish I could walk around them, look on the inside of them. Wish they had the hood up. Was 750. How you doing? Man, they got some nice trucks in there. This video gonna take a long time. Y'all, I'm gonna have to break this video up into parts. They got a bunch of trucks in here. They even got the police in here. It's a Model A paddy wagon. Excuse me. Hey, Boogaloo, I told you they got paddy wagons. That's for my son, y'all. I told him there's paddy wagons out there. Look at that. 1933 Ford Model A paddy wagon. Ford snowmobile. Ford A snowmobile. Now that is something. I didn't even know Ford made snowmobiles. This is a U.S. mail truck, so this is the post office vehicle. This particular one says U.S. mail on the back there. Model TT, 1 ton. Ford Model TT. Iowa 80 Group Diamond 1948 FDD 6 on the flathead engine, top speed 45 miles an hour. The Unimog multi-purpose Mercedes-Benz. German. And they're still making them today. And the axles are up higher than the tires, according to the higher than the center of the tires. That's your first super single right there. That tie wide. I guess that's the first super single. International. I guess Cleveland got backup. Armored car. Law enforcement. International, 1939, D15, 45 mile an hour top speed. And another international harvester, 20 years later. 28 years later. Then the red one down there I just showed you. Deuce and a quarter, 1924. Brockway. Next to it, Brockway 260, 1949. Now we're getting into the trucks that I'm more familiar with. The ones I see on old TV. I don't see nothing like them down there. The old Mack. Connodine. See, got that gold dog on it. Everything. The motor, the transmission, and the rear ends are all Mack. I know that from the gold dog on it. That's something for if y'all didn't know. If it got a gold dog, Mack made everything. If the dog is silver, like all the rest of them that y'all finna see, Mack didn't make the complete driveline. They probably got driveline from other people. Well, ain't no problem. They did get a driveline from other people. 1964 Mack B 783SX. These some heavy trucks right here. And this one got a sleeper. Look at that. Got a little sleeper back there. 1960. That long wheelbase. What wheelbase that is? So this last truck y'all just seen, this one was still being used in the business. It's a 1960 and he used it for 30 years. He used it for 30 years and then the museum actually bought it directly from the guy who bought it brand new. So it was still in use until it came to the museum. '55 Mack LTL with a huge tank, a fuel tank on that thing. Like you got either, you got two lines on it. That's a long frame though. It got to be a winch truck. It look like it got a winch on the back. So it's a 5-speed with a 3-speed auxiliary. And it's a 34-inch aluminum sleeper that's added. And they use it in the oil field. So they took the, they had a sleeper on it, and they took it off in order to use it on the oil field. A log truck. See, when they were logging, I know they'll pick that piece up. They'll pick the piece up off the top of it, boom, and set it down behind it. Then he'll hook up to it. And then they'll throw the logs on there. See that? There's an example. It doesn't even got a doze on it. Heavy haul truck. Out of New Jersey. That's where Mac get the name from, the Bulldog. That's why they got the dog on the front of the truck, because they said this truck looked like a bulldog with a short nose on it. Dang, that truck big. I got it stand way back on the other side of the hallway. It's international, that last one. What kind of truck this is? I ain't ever seen one of these. Look at that super single bike there. He got a front and back. Ryder Paymaster. The Paymaster was designed in the late 60s by truck inventor David in Oregon. Wanted to build a truck that would be more aerodynamic, more fuel efficient, and that was easy to maintain. Wheel shaped cab, roof mounted spoiler, had smoother flow over and around the truck and trailer. After building two initial units, design was sold to Ryder Corporation, who commissioned Hendrickson to build 10 units for its fleet for testing. Due to the economy at the time, the low driver acceptance, the design was returned to David. Three more units of an updated design were built, but there wasn't enough interest to further the production. So that was thinking about aerodynamics long time ago. Now this is a K-Whopper. This is an American K-Whopper. I can't wear. This truck just got too many lights on it for me. They got way too many lights on it for me. I guess they bought it like this though. Alright, now we're going at the end of the hallway, y'all. I'm coming around to the other side. This is a Kenworth also. ...1952 Kenworth. With a three-axle utility trailer, model KCK-825C. Bull nose. Old radiators, old Cummins NH250. Oh, drag racing. Bandag Bandit. Bandag Bandit, old dragster. Horsepower. Ooh. Top speed 150 miles an hour. Let me go back to this Mac right here. No, it's KW. My bad. I'm sorry, y'all. It's Kenworth. She leaking a little oil there. Wouldn't be a truck old as it is. Hey. Old as she is, she doing pretty good. We're going to walk back around her in a little bit. Half-ton delivery truck, VIM, VIM 1913. We'll check out these when we come back around. Cause they're, yeah, all the signs for them on the other side. Cab over, 1983 Ford. I don't know the name of this truck or who made it. They have nothing up here. Consolidated Freight with Wahees. It's a freight liner. Look at that. Gas back in the day. 39 cents a gallon. Including taxes. We need to go back to them days. 39 cents a gallon. Oh, another Mac. Another bull nose Mac. It's a house mover. Now, what is this? Oh, Sterling. Another Mac FJ tanker. Guess what? Another electric vehicle. These are the trucks that are still waiting to be restored. Another Brockway. And the first Peterbilt in the video. The first Peterbilt in the video. Cummins Model 6 HB. 18 speed is the top speed. 18 miles per hour. And a Ford. I couldn't tell you what model Ford this is. If you know, comment in below. Comment down below. All right. Special edition. Look like you got an APU on it. Look like they put an APU on a truck. Yeah. Yep, they put an APU on the truck.
Well, that's on me because it's the last time.
Mustang. Super white Mustang. Dodge. Dodge C600. Peterbilt, cab over. Freightliner. Peterbilt, 358. All right, delivery truck. Oh my God. You guys saw this truck right here. This is another racing truck or something like that, cause it got a bunch of stickers on it. So let's see. Let's see. Let's see. Yep, race truck. Knew it. Too many stickers on it. Oh, another bull nose. Big brute, 10 ton, 20,000 pounds. So hard for these trucks to stop back in the day. They only had brakes on the back. Brakes only on the back. International. Sac City, Iowa. Diamond T. Packard. Dump truck. All right, that's a dump truck too. Not a dump truck, a roll off.
Rambler, 1913 Rambler. 42 horsepower. Boy, that truck has some get up, bro. International. All right, now we're gonna go on over here. GMC Truck and Truck and Coach Division. Manufactured by General Motors. We got CFI. We got CFI now. They're like a Kenworth. That one a Kenworth. It looked like, yeah. There's just some storage, and I ain't gonna show y'all all up in there. This truck old as I am. Me and the truck made in the same year. Dustin too. Well, I was made in 85. I was born in 86. That truck was made the year I was born. Yeah, we got a whole long way to go. We still got the middle to do, and then go up the other side.